Blackstone Publishing presents Three Sisters in Black, The Bizarre True Case of the Bathtub Tragedy by Norman Zierold. This book is read by Gabrielle de Cuir. 1. To stargazers on the eastern seaboard, November 27, 1909, was memorable for a total eclipse of the moon, which shrouded the night in densest black. For inhabitants of East Orange, New Jersey, then a quiet residential suburb of New York, the darkness later seemed a sinister omen, an angry augury. The next day, Sunday, remained cool and gray. On Monday afternoon, November 29, a telephone call pierced the small town stillness, opening one of the most macabre crime mysteries in modern times. At 388 Main Street, East Orange Police Headquarters, Sergeant Timothy Caniff picked up the receiver. He noted the time as 4:40 p.m. At the other end of the line, a woman's voice, soft and cultivated, asked whether a coroner could be sent immediately to her house. There had been an accident. The sergeant explained that the county had no coroner's office. He would send out a physician. The soft voice gave an address, 89 North 14th Street, and hung up. Unable to reach the county physician, Caniff called his assistant, Herbert M. Simmons. Dr. Simmons walked to the designated location from his nearby office, crossing the Lackawanna Railroad overpass, then continuing three short blocks on North 14th Street before reaching number 89. A cheerless gray frame house of two stories topped by an attic. Medical satchel in hand, he was climbing the porch steps when the front door opened. Before him stood a tall, spare woman dressed all in black, a long cape flowing to the ground, heavy veils secreting the face. Startled by this somber apparition, the physician was relieved to hear the pleasing accents of the South in the voice that beckoned to him.
"Please come in," it said. "I am Virginia Wardlaw."
Simmons identified himself. Silently, the woman in black led him up a flight of stairs and down the second floor hallway. Open doors along the way gave no sign of occupancy. At the end of the hall, the woman halted. Simmons hesitated, knowing he was about to see what he had come for, the intractable face of death. For the physician, it was an everyday experience, and yet one to which he was never fully reconciled. Steeling himself, he turned the knob, pushed the door, and saw that he had entered the bathroom. There it was, the nude body of a young woman in a small half-filled bathtub. The slender figure was in a crouching position, legs doubled up at the knees, the left hand lightly grasping a washcloth, the head submerged in the cold bathwater and tipped slightly to the right, directly under the faucet. Long auburn hair streamed like a fan on the water. The physician gently raised the head and saw a face that must, in life, have been very beautiful. Each feature fine and classically formed, dominated by large brown eyes, now fixed in a sightless stare. After a preliminary inspection of the body, Simmons's attention shifted to a pile of clothing on the floor. To one of the garments, a note was pinned. The physician read the bold, clear handwriting. "Last year, my little daughter died. Other near and dear ones have gone before. I have been prostrated with illness for a long time. When you read this, I will have committed suicide. Do not grieve over me. Rejoice with me that death brings a blessed relief from pain and suffering greater than I can bear. O.W.M. Snead."
"Who is this woman?"
Simmons asked the veiled figure in the doorway.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.